The ultimate smartphone video kit, right here. Inside this little thing. Look at this guy. This is from Peak Designs. The little three litter sling. But inside of it, I have everything I need to make some seriously wild cinematic video footage things. Creatives, wanna be an indie filmmaker? You wanna record your family moments? You wanna get smooth, buttery gimbal shots? Let's look inside. So we've got the Movi Freefly gimbal here. Then, can you see in this little pocket? I've got three lenses for my iPhone. Look at the glass on these guys. See that? See the way the light reflects off of it? See all that stuff? That makes for some interesting looking shots. So you gotta get a phone case from them. These are Moment lenses. The whole question is, do they make a case for your phone? And will they make a case for your next phone? And your next phone, and your next phone, and your next phone? Why? Whoa. Because these things are getting updated all the time. Their software is incredible and it's getting updated all the time. The technology, the actual physical hard goods stuff inside is getting updated all the time. So these lenses might be more valuable than you'd think. Everybody at the beginning thinks that these are like really, you know, gimmicky. My iPhone already has a lens on it. It has three actually, right? But this one right here, the top one, that one gets me the best possible settings, the best aperture and all that stuff. So I can throw wide angle lens, telephoto lens, anamorphic lens right on that. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about my experience with three things, okay? Number one, the Moment lenses. Number two, the Movi Freefly gimbal, which is sensational, but is it worth it? Is it worth the price? And then number three, the Filmic Pro app, as well as the Moment apps for the phone, because these things can film in like 60 frames a second, 120 frames a second, 240 frames a second. These things actually do a dang good job of autofocus, of setting the, you know, exposure for your scene automatically. Before I go any further, this video is sponsored by Moment. All the thoughts you're gonna hear are my own, but they sponsor this video, so thanks Moment. Shopmoment.com. By the way, they're doing an amazing job of like creating a little like curated branch of the internet for products that we need for, as like, you know, indie creators and stuff, but also their YouTube channels. Fun AF. Autofocus. Another thing that Moment sent me, thank you Moment, was this Rode little microphone, but I haven't used it very much. So I won't be talking about this very much, but you can get, like, from what I've tested so far, pretty decent audio. And before I go any further, just that Peak Design 3-liter sling, I was sliding this over in one of these side compartments over here. It's a little bit of a tight squeeze, but it's super soft. And what that means is I've got all this space for my gimbal. Okay, and then up top in this little organization pouch up here, I've got space for my lenses. And on the front here, I've got space for a filter mount and some ND filters. Okay, so these Moment lenses is a quick upgrade to your phone. You gotta get a case, they gotta make a case for your phone. The way that they slide on is great. Actually, I was super impressed by the actual just manufacturing of these things. Just the physicality. The way that they look and feel, it's nice. It's a quick upgrade to your phone. Each lens costs about 120 bucks, but if you group them together, it's like 180 for two. They sent me three. The anamorphic, which is unbelievable. 18 millimeter, they also have a 14 millimeter fisheye, and then the 58 millimeter telephoto. They also have a macro lens, which you can get really close to things with. Now, one of the other things here is you can get one of these little filter adapters, which slide right onto the each individual lens. You get a little centerpiece that can come out, and that allows you to take an ND filter and screw that right on, and now you've got an anamorphic lens with an ND filter on your phone, because cinema! They do make ND filters that can go directly onto here. You can use a built-in lens, but then have an ND filter, so you're allowing that aperture to open up as much as possible. Like I said, you wanna make sure that they have a case for your phone. I live out of my Belroy 3-card wallet case. This is my wallet. They do have some wallet cases, but they don't have one for the iPhone 11 yet, Pro. It'll be interesting to see how they're able to keep up with, you know, the phones over time, because it's not easy to do. And I don't know who's running that company. It seems like it's a bunch of children over there. It's a telephoto 58, an 18 millimeter, and my anamorphic, which I'm gonna show you in a second what that does. The anamorphic is so sick, but it's also strange. It's like, I don't really want to recommend it, but it's so sick. And then the ND filter and adapters if you need that. But let's say you didn't need that. Here's everything you need right here. There's your whole camera rig. There's my camera rig right there in the palm of my hands. I can literally pocket all of these in my pants.
So there's everything I need right there.
And of course the AirPods just there to help you understand the size and because they're also in my pocket. So the first thing that's sensational about these for regular everyday use is that they're really convenient. The second thing that's great is they're built really well so they feel solid, like they feel actually really great to click in, click out and use. They feel trusty. The third thing that's great is that you get to use your best camera on your phone, whichever one can get you the best aperture and the best of the things. The fourth thing that's great though is you can use the other ones. Like for instance, using the 58 millimeter telephoto on the telephoto lens on the iPhone, you get a very long shot. It's interesting to be able to do that with just, here you are. There it is. The fifth thing that's great is it gives you the ability to put on an ND filter. So when you're shooting outside, now you can either add an ND filter on top of these or use one of their ND filters that just goes right on your built-in lens. But one of the fascinating things about these that I've found is that they really do make the shots feel and look a little bit different. There's some lens flares going on. The way that all of that glass captures and pulls in the light you see it in the frame in all sorts of like lens stuff. It's still really sharp edge to edge. It's got tons of durability, but I like the, I don't know, it makes it feel a little more airy, a little more atmospheric. But that's not essential. That kind of flare, that kind of cinematic vibe is, I don't feel like it's essential to be able to make, you know, good creative videos. It's just, it's nice, it's helpful. But then there's this anamorphic lens. Here's the deal. This anamorphic lens pulls in from the sides, right? And then you have those black bars on the top and the bottom. So that's why I don't feel super comfortable recommending it. But the way the footage looks, you guys. Holy shit, it just has a completely different quality. Now, very few of us are watching our video that we're taking on our phone on some big screen, right? Which is where we're used to seeing those black bars. Maybe we're watching it on YouTube where the black bars aren't, it's not that bad. Maybe we're filming everything in anamorphic and there aren't black bars, you just have a much wider frame. It's awfully specific, this anamorphic sort of size, but the movement in the camera, the way that it pulls the sides in, I just think I just want to experiment so much more with it. And by the way, the apps I'm going to talk about in part three of this video have the ability to de-squeeze that footage automatically when it's being saved. Okay, then there's this Movi gimbal, the Movi FreeFly. Now there are several other gimbals on the market that are actually more affordable. This thing comes in at like $299 at the time of making this. Check the price in the link below because you know, could be changing. But like, there's a few other things like the Zhiyun is $130, but the Osmo Mobile 3 is like $120. The problem with that one is you can't do a counterweight system on it. At least at this time you can't. So you can't really use any of these moment lenses there. Well, you might be able to with this, because this is really, really light in comparison to these bigger ones. I'm also really interested to see what like the Osmo Pocket would be like. What if you just got rid of all of this and just had that little Osmo Pocket? That also slides in your pocket. But I can't imagine that the Osmo Pocket has as much control as you can have with like a Filmic Pro app, your gimbal, your lenses, all that kind of stuff. I mean, this is what's so crazy is, here's my setup right here. The amount of things that I can do with this for video are ridiculous. So Moment sent this one out and I'm glad they did, because here's one of the things that I love about it is it's really durably built. It actually doesn't feel like the plastic is, it's plasticky and it feels like it's like a matte plastic. The buttons aren't that nice, but they're like, the more you use them, the more you're like, Actually, this is super trusty. You've got a USB-C right here. It does quick charging. Battery lasts about 8 hours. Quarter 20 thread right here for zipping into a tripod, which ends up being surprisingly helpful because you can actually program this to do some movements for you. Then there's a record button right here, which works in some of the apps I'll be talking about, and a trigger button that allows you to use their own app, the Movi app, to do certain maneuvers. It connects to your phone via Bluetooth, so you can actually do these programmable movements and stuff like that in the Movi app. Like, I can have it pan across the room and follow me at a certain, like, pace. Very clear here, it does not follow you. You set a motion path. Here's where I want you to start. Here's where I want you to finish. It's like, cool, I'll take care of it from here. And then you can you can walk in its way. That's also really useful for time lapse. So you can get this like nice movement in this long clip of time lapse. The Movi app or whatever makes time lapse stuff go, it's killer. But the big thing about this are the smooth moves, X-Lax. So much is communicated through the movement in your camera. When my camera's here just static like this, that's a thing that's being communicated. But the moment you get that onto a gimbal and you have this really smooth movement, that means my eye, the viewer's eye, can be focused on specific things within the frame. You can focus on more of the action that's going on in the frame as opposed to the action of the cameraman or woman tripping over something. For tracking shots where you're following alongside someone or behind someone or in front of someone, this is sensational. For selfie shots, it's actually really great. You're putting this thing like this, you're panning it around the room, you're looking around, you can get up and go on walks with this thing. It's definitely an interesting vibe. I liked it for walk and talk, like I could walk and talk to the camera, and here's how I'm holding it, just like this, right? So this little red area over here, this is like a great little handle. Now, one thing you need to know about this is there's a few different controls you have on screen. This is inside the Movi app here. You can go slow, medium, or fast response. Medium's what I go. Slow is I move a lot, and then it moves. I move a lot, and then it moves. And then you can change this window, how much you allow it to move before it starts moving with you, so you can get extremely smooth, buttery stuff going on, or go a little bit faster, lower the window, and it's like right there with all your movements, you get a lot of crazy stuff going on. But it's still smoothing it out. That's what's so fascinating, and you notice it. There's also a few different modes. The majestic mode is what I use almost all the time, except for when I go into echo or the time-lapse mode. Movi lapse is really interesting because it's for time-lapse while you're moving. But in this echo mode, I can just tell it to go move to the right, and I can set my duration, how long I want it to go. So this one you can see as it moves, it's just super interesting. So you put that down on the ground and track out where you're gonna walk and walk in front of this thing, and it'll track you. Then I hit that trigger again and that starts the action, that also stops the action. Here's my record button. My big question is, in the future, is this gonna be able to, you know, software, hardware, interacting here, using some Bluetooth to be able to actually track a subject in front of the camera, like actually move with them, not just go along a programmed path. Also, as you're looking at this thing, you can see these weights. These are a counterweight system that is designed to work with this guy, just for lenses like this. Maybe for bigger, weird phones, if phones get really long at some point, it's gonna come in handy too. But this kind of counterweight system is necessary for any gimbal, basically, because you don't know exactly what you're gonna be putting on here. Also, can't be easier to open and close this thing. Well, look at my window. Oh no, it's freaking out. But just to show you that this thing moves open and closes really easily, you put your phone in effortlessly on this counterweight system. You've got a space to be able to get a cord in there, so if I was connecting my microphone, I could do that there. There's also, Movi makes a little clip that goes onto this little nubbin. See, you gotta just get it right over the tip, And then you've got access to all these buttons still, but you've got a little threaded screw guy right here, so I could put this microphone or a light right on that rig. That is something I'm probably going to be purchasing. I didn't know anything about gimbals before I started using this thing. By the way, there's a little click in here. You can click it, and that kind of puts it to sleep, even if it's on, but it also makes it nice for putting it in the bag. It kind of locks things together. But here's the deal. I didn't know anything about gimbals before using this thing. It made it really, really, really easy. It feels extremely solid, really robust, sort of simple in the app. I don't use the app. I'll tell you what I do use on my phone in just a second that does integrate with this thing. That means I can actually use these buttons on the Filmic Pro app, and I can control everything on my camera using just these. This gets very interesting. But it is kind of big to bring around compared to this little, like, you know, you just got the little things in your hands and your pockets. This is kind of a bummer to have to bring around, but the truth is what it adds to the shot, the fact that I can just be using my phone and get these really smooth, cinematic, interesting moments. I mean, even if you're just filming your family, just keeping stuff for the personal vault that one day you're gonna look back with your spouse after you guys have separated, and then, like, you know, like, I gotta imagine that divorced people sometimes hook up and like later on. And after that would be a great time to watch some family movies with the way that you guys have built these lives together. That's probably totally unnecessary. I didn't need to say that. But that's the one thing about this, is that it's a little bit of a bummer to bring around. It's just big. It causes me to have to bring at least something. Whereas, honestly, a tiny little fanny pack. Well, this is actually how I found out about these guys. This is the Moment fanny pack. They sent one of these over because I do bag reviews most of the time, and bags are sort of my thing. And I was playing with this and I'm like, this is a damn good bag. Who's Moment? Moment are making bags? And they're not making bags at all. They've been making these, and they just happened to put one of these together, and it's killer. It actually has spots for your lenses and stuff, and then all the little organization that you need. So this is like, oh, for your phone, a little snack, put a little super fat in there. If you don't know about these are delicious. I'll put a link below. But this isn't gonna fit in there. So that's what I mean by it's a kind of a bummer. It's a little bit of like I'm making that decision. The Osmo Mobile 3 is smaller. I still don't think that would fit in here. Maybe it would, but you wouldn't be able to use their lenses. So we're back at this conversation around the most minimal way of getting footage that you're gonna use, be able to use either in, you know, creative videos or just for recording family moments or whatever, without having so much stuff, or even a big old DSLR, right? So it's kind of a bummer to have to bring this thing around. It's also kind of like, you know, it looks funky. People are like, what the fuck is this guy doing? Filming his kids, doing something? Who does he think he is? But the footage, you guys. So super smooth moves. Cool little programmable things that you can do that actually are, like, when I say programmable, some of you are like, oh, I don't want to read the manual. I didn't. You really don't have to. But it's kind of a bummer to bring around, because the dream of this iPhone photography is just this. It's like, this is all I really need. So to add this in is somewhat of a bummer. So what if you just were using your phone? You've already got, like, whatever you put on top of this is going to be using whatever lens is built in there, right? So it's not like we're making that lens better, we're making it different. I think you could argue we're kind of making it better, because the way the footage just looks, the image, the light, does, you're capturing things differently because you have this huge piece of glass on the front. But what if you're just using your phone and you want to be able to control all the things, okay? That's where these apps come in. Filmic Pro, there's the Movi app in the middle, and then the Moment app. All of these are, well, only use the Movi if you have the gimbal. By the way, pro trick, you see that right there? That is a remote for Filmic Pro. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, I can put that Filmic remote app on my, I don't know why I went all, but wait, there's more. I can put the Filmic remote app on another phone or on my iPad, and then set this camera up like this with Filmic on it, and then control it all with my iPad So I'm looking at the shot that I'm in. This is very interesting for you people like me who end up filming a lot of videos where you're talking into a lens, pretending that there's people paying attention, but you don't really know what it looks like. Now, the Moment app, I'd say, is my preferred for the way it looks, but I have used the Filmic app more often, even though it doesn't have the best user interface. The Filmic app interface is not that bad. It's just, it feels sort of strange sometimes. Now, Filmic has this Log V2, which I think you might have to do another upgrade to the app to get it, but it's very interesting to get all that flat sort of look to your footage that you can color grade later on. And both of these apps have the ability to manually control exposure just here on the screen like this, and focus. Am I getting focus? Wait for it. You see that little green? The Filmic has this great way of showing you what's in focus and what isn't. Now that feature right there automatically takes this into like a, we can do a lot with our phones, dude. You can set this thing up on a tripod using like the, my favorite little glyph, and all of a sudden you can set up shots, control your light completely, change your ISO, and set a manual focus. So you're like out of focus, out off screen, like walking in towards screen, sitting down, you're doing that whole interview thing. Now, the simplest thing in the world is when you have exposure somewhere and then autofocus somewhere, and you can lock that in. My exposure is gonna stay right there now because it's red, or my focus, I can lock that in right there. That's easy. What's awesome about this is you can rely on your camera's autofocus, which for me, who's shot on a Panasonic GH4, before that a GH2, I've never had autofocus in a video camera before this, basically. And it does a good job, but you do need to watch out for what I call crap face. When you're moving through different lighting sources, sometimes the phone can get a little confused. Just another place you've got to think as a filmmaker, like where am I going? What is the purpose of the shot? Where's the light? How am I doing? I don't know. Learning how to be a cinematographer is like, I don't know. I should probably go to school for this sort of thing, but I'll just watch YouTube videos instead. So all the focus, all the exposure, all the ISO or the shutter speed, all of the different frame rates and resolution sizes on your phone, right? 240. Filmic Pro also does a great job with audio devices. I had no idea there was multiple mics on my iPhone. If you have the AirPods plugged in, it'll automatically send you the monitoring of what's being recorded through there. Super great stuff. Now, Filmic, you can set to save things directly to your camera roll or to its own little storage device in your phone. For me, I have an iPhone, so I plug in my iPhone to my computer, I see it in Finder, I can then download or move things one at a time right now. It's not the best vibe. But I do like having my Filmic footage separate from my regular photos, which is all just like family stuff, and the Filmic stuff I'm oftentimes using for videos like these. Okay, now these two together, Filmic Pro and this thing, are unreal because I can like lock in my exposure. I can move my exposure up and down. I can do the same thing with my focus. I can long press over here and now I'm in like autofocus mode. I can do all that stuff. Or I can go back to auto. I can do different kinds of modes. All of that's right here. I can trigger recording right here. I can do all of that. I can even change the mode here. I don't know how to do all the things. I'll link to an instructional video below where it'll teach you how to do all the things. But one mode, for example, is freeze mode. It'll freeze the camera just exactly how it is. Another mode is this majestic mode where it'll move according to your movements. That's what's so sick about this. It just like, you end up getting a really good feel for the movement as you're watching the screen and moving stuff around. It just has a totally different vibe when you're filming that way. And to use the Filmic Pro app with this, where you can do everything basically without touching your screen at all, is kind of like, whoa, you can get good at this. The same setup like that, where you have gimbal smooth with a DSLR, where you've got, the DSLR is gonna do a much better job at all the things, right? But it's so big, it's so cumbersome. This all fit in this tiny little bag, you guys. So Moment have this as like a little filmmaker kit with the anamorphic and this, where I think you save a little bit of bones doing it that way. I'll be using it in my personal life for sure, because I can't get enough of the way that that looks, like the walk and talks and things like that. I'll be using it here on the channel and really to record my, you know, the family moments. I'm trying to figure out exactly how I'm going to be managing footage, and like, seems like the job right now, if you're gonna be a YouTuber, is you gotta create a library of footage throughout the days, weeks, and months, right? So you can use that in video, because I'm always testing different things at multiple things at the same time. Well, this is probably one of the better rigs I could use for doing that, because I get all that smooth move, X-Lax. And the really challenging thing for me about this is the anamorphic, because it looks so good. It just looks so interesting, but it's so specific. The way that it pulls in the scene from the outside, it's just like, oh, this shot makes so much more sense. It feels so good moving through spaces. Okay, so that's what I've learned. That's my take. That's what's going on with this. That's like I think it's all actually really worth it. It's a very interesting thing to go screw the DSLR, screw all of that. I'm going just with my iPhone. I'm going with Moment lenses because it pulls in the light a little bit different, and a gimbal. But, you know, I just got another camera, so I'm excited to use that too, which is what I'm recording on right here. And that does pretty damn good at image stabilization, both in the lenses and in the body. Now I have this, like, I'm feeling pulled apart, right? So for $3,000+, you can get a badass DSLR, and then you have to carry that, lug that around, feel the feeling of what it would be like if that got stolen. For a lot less, you're in something like this. I mean, because you already have the phone. Right? And you're probably gonna be upgrading this phone all the time. Like every year, every 2 years. What's your cycle, bro? And this thing's gonna work no matter what your phone is, basically. These things are gonna work no matter what your phone is. So even if you don't use these and you just use the phone, this right here isn't that big of a setup, and you could, I just, like, that's where maybe what the best scenario is you go for the Osmo, am I saying that right? Like the Osmo Mobile 3, which I've never used, so I don't know. But that with just your iPhone as it is, no lenses, and just go like, fuck it, I'm doing it live. Cause that's really quite minimal. I think it might even fit in here. So for B-roll and getting all that stuff. And then, do you know that you can start editing things in iMovie on your phone and then export that out to FCP like later on? So you're in a taxi ride in Hong Kong on your way back from shooting something, and you're already doing like a little rough cut. This is, as one of the Moment videos said, if this isn't the future of filmmaking, I don't know what is. Links to everything is below. Please subscribe if you like this. Though this isn't what I typically do. I do normally, anyways, subscribe if you like this. If you're interested in free gear, definitely go over to Matterful.co. I'll link to it just below, and get on the email list, because we basically only use that email there for freebie giveaways. And I am on Patreon. I don't know if that's your thing. If you're a follower here, if you've been here for a while, now might be the time. Jump on Patreon. I've made a few videos recently that are just for patrons. So love you. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.